Today we're going to explore the 5 science-based tips on how I, as a student, shake off that constant tiredness, stop being a walking zombie, and finally catapult our energy levels to reach those new levels of success. You see, I've already seen many videos made on this topic on how not to constantly be tired all the time, and they generally focus on the big 3: sleep, exercise, and diet. And after doing much research, of course, sleep, exercise, and diet are absolutely crucial, but I wanted to give you 5 tips that are quite different from those espoused in many other videos that touch the same topic. If you're anything like me, you want to be as ambitious as Elon Musk and have the crazy energy that Kevin Hart has every single day to achieve your overly ambitious goals. But you always run into the same problem. Your energy levels suddenly drop drastically during the day, and then you no longer have the energy to actually achieve all the things you want to achieve. And if you are anything like me, you are spending way too much time on YouTube looking for artificial, inspirational content that will suddenly motivate you to get these things done and get your ass out of bed. You see, in today's culture, we are surrounded with what I like to call energy sucking devices. That could be your computer, your phone, TV, Netflix, Hulu, all of the new things, TikTok. All of these things are energy sucking devices, and they bring down your plateau of available energy during the day to achieve all of the things you want to achieve. So let's jump into the tips to navigate this energy sucking culture that surrounds all of us. But before we start, if you're new here, my name is Diego and this is Apex of Man. I'm an undergraduate studying business and computer science at Boston University. And if you're obsessed with productivity, self-development, lifestyle design, and being a master of your routine and your habits, be sure to smash that subscribe button. New videos out every single week. Let's go. So of course, as I mentioned, sleep, exercise, and diet are crucial to maintaining your energy levels during the day. But I want to delve a little deeper into sleep and give you a few key points that will absolutely hypercharge your ability to sleep and allow you to be much more rested and ready to crush the day. So obviously, sleeping 7 to 8 hours a day is absolutely necessary, unless you're one of those crazy vampires that doesn't need any sleep. But what if you could go to bed and wake up without even setting an alarm? That is what I want to talk about right now. And this all boils down to understanding your organic sleep cycle. You see, sleep is divided into 4 phases: NREM stage 1, NREM stage 2, NREM stage 3, and REM sleep. Understanding the difference between all of these phases is absolutely necessary to understand at what point you need to wake up during these sleep cycles. So for example, REM sleep is the deepest sleep that you are involved in during the night. And waking up in the middle of a REM sleep cycle is like being hit by a truck in the morning. So that is what you do not want to do. You want to time your wake up so that you are not in the REM sleep phase, but you are in one of the other 3 preferably. These phases of sleep generally take around the same amount of time. So if you plan what time you go to bed and what time you wake up, you can actually make a pretty good estimate to wake up during one of the 3 sleep stages that are actually during your lightest sleep, and you won't feel like you got just punched in the face by Mike Tyson in the morning. But how exactly do you do this? In the past, I have used sleepytie.me, linked down in the description, to estimate my ideal wake up time. This is an online tool that allows you to set your bedtime and the time you want to wake up so that you maximally rest during the night and wake up during one of the lighter phases of your sleep. And again, as I mentioned, after many iterations of doing this day by day, your sleep cycle will start adjusting and you will probably not need an alarm anymore. And you will have that absolutely wonderful feeling of waking up in the morning right before your alarm and just being ready to crush the day. Number 2 has everything to do with using caffeine properly. Personally, I only drink coffee very strategically during periods of time where I have intense hustles ahead of me or where my energy levels during the day are very, very low and I have a big project that I need to complete in a very short time span. However, if you're a caffeine junkie, I'm not going to tell you to quit caffeine all of a sudden because that is not realistic for most of us, but I am going to give you a few tips that I've encountered during my research and reading certain books such as Make Time, a fantastic book, that will allow you to use caffeine properly during the day, not have those caffeine crashes, and then be able to rest soundly at night without suffering from some crazy caffeine-induced insomnia. It is important to understand that caffeine has a half-life of 5 to 7 hours. hours. Therefore, if you take your last cup of coffee at 5 p.m. and you're going to bed at 10, 11, when you go to bed, still half of that caffeine is in your system and it will disrupt your body's organic ability to produce melatonin and fall asleep at the time you want it to fall asleep. So if you stop having coffee by 12 p.m., your body will thank you for it and you will have much better rest at night and actually fall asleep at 10, 11 to be able to wake up early and crush the day. So Ryan, one of the authors of Make Time, was able to create this personalized system that allowed him to use caffeine efficiently. But I do suggest you experiment with caffeine and build your own personalized system that works for you and your organism and your individual sleep cycle and organic melatonin production. Again, this Make Time book is fantastic and I highly suggest you read it. There is an entire chapter dedicated to using caffeine properly. So if you're a caffeine junkie, I really suggest you pick up the book. It's an absolutely fantastic productivity book and it will cut your dependency on caffeine. Number three is all about harnessing natural and artificial light. This is something that I haven't seen many people talk about on YouTube. As we mentioned, there is this internal system that regulates your sleep through the production of melatonin, which is that hormone that makes you sleepy at night. This system is called the circadian rhythm, and it goes way back to the days when we were cavemen and we depended on the sun to regulate the time when we woke up and the time when we went to bed. However, nowadays with all of these digital technologies and these artificial lights, our brain and our circadian rhythms are completely out of whack, especially if you're one of those people that goes to bed checking their phone or being on Instagram for an hour or watching Netflix. That triggers your brain to think that it's still daytime, and then you cannot go to bed until it's like 2 or 3 a.m. when you're absolutely smashed. So make sure you harness natural and artificial light. Let's start with natural light. Make sure you get out there, especially during these times of quarantine. Make sure you go to your balcony or open your window, whatever you need to do, and get some direct sunlight exposure, because sunlight exposure is linked with maintaining healthy melatonin levels and allowing you to fall asleep at night. And if you live very, very far away from the equator, maybe you're watching this video from Antarctica, I don't know, take some vitamin D supplements to simulate that natural light and be able to maintain those melatonin levels. And now in terms of artificial light, something that has really worked for me in the past month is buying sunlight simulating light bulbs. You see those nice little lights back there, the ones that give that orange and blue tinge to the bookcase? Those are Philips Hue light bulbs and they can simulate the sun rising in the morning. I try to wake up every day at 5 a.m. and at 5 a.m. in Spain, there's no sunlight. So when you open your window, you look out and it's really, really dark, and many times I've woken up seeing that it's still dark and I just go back to bed and roll back to bed. But recently, in the past week, I have actually used the sunlight simulating function of these Philips Hue, and they simulate sunlight artificially before you wake up, and you wake up really, really refreshed and feeling absolutely fantastic. There are many, many cheaper alternatives than the Philips Hue light bulbs. I will try to link them in the description below, but I really suggest you buy them, especially if you live in a country where you wake up before the sun rises. Tip number four has everything to do with embracing the cold. Harnessing cold is an incredible way to activate your energy during the day, especially as students right now that we are so bogged down doing online classes and studying from home that you start feeling very groggy and very stagnant in the same location. And now that it's winter, everybody has a very warm thermostat and it just makes you so sleepy that there is no way that you can have the long-term energy you need during the day to do all the things you need. So make sure that your thermostat is not too high to induce that sleep. Also, make sure that when you start feeling groggy, you go outside, get some fresh air, get some cold wind in your face to wake you up. And if you can't do that or you don't want to do that, hop into a cold shower and truly just blast it really, really fast. Get in there quick. You don't even have to put soap on if you're trying to save time. Just get into the shower, turn it as cold as you can, and it will give you such a jolt in those times when you're having that crash, particularly that afternoon slump, usually after eating lunch. It will be an absolute game changer, I promise. And the last tip I want to talk about is doing more things every single day. Have you ever felt that when you do more things during the day, your energy plateau is higher and you can do more things? And those days when you're feeling groggy and lazy and you don't do anything, you're particularly tired. So there have apparently been many studies that have linked doing more things during the day with having a higher energy plateau. So the more things you do, the more energy you create and the more your body becomes used to doing those things. If you don't do anything during the day, or you're a lazy slob, or you do very few things, and just then throw in the towel and say, okay, I'm done, I'm gonna watch YouTube or watch Netflix or roam social media, then your energy levels will never rise to the level they can. So maybe you have really low expectations in terms of what your energy levels can do. And one of the ways you can test this out is by scheduling a very busy day, trying to stick to it. Don't overcumber yourself, because if it's excessively busy, you will never stick to it. But try and have a pretty full day where you're productive in work and you go to the gym and maybe you hang out with some people and you have a busy day, a day that requires activity and a lot of energy. And you will see that at the end of the day, you feel great. You don't feel like a slob, you don't feel really tired, but you feel good enough to go to bed and start the next day. So make sure you harness the power of doing more things and having higher responsibilities throughout your life and being able to unlock those new levels of energy. It's like a video game. You just need to keep rising through those levels. So those were the 5 science-backed tips on how to unlock new levels of energy and achieve greatness as a student. If you're still hanging around here, welcome to the end of the video club. It's great to have you here. And if you want to support the channel and ensure that other people can improve their routines and habits and we keep growing our community, make sure to smash that subscribe button, leave a like, and leave a comment. So maybe the algorithm gods bless us with pushing this video to the feeds of other people who are not subscribed and they can gain some value from more videos like this. And if you're interested in improving your routine during quarantine, check out these videos right here where I discuss some hacks on how to unlock higher productivity levels during quarantine. Thanks for the support. See you in the next video.